Hi there and welcome to another video from Hegarty Maths. It's Mr. Hegarty here, and in this video we are solving one-step equations using what's called the balance method. Let's start with the puzzle we did on the last video where we were solving equations using inverse operations. Pause the video and double check you can find my number using inverse operations. Hopefully you drew something like this, a flowchart, and you found that x, my original number, was 2.4. When I showed you that skill in the last video, I said an alternative way of writing it was in the following way. And this method is actually called the balance method. And that's what I'm going to use from now on. And I'm not going to use the flowchart method anymore. It's a bit unwieldy, and this is going to be much more useful to us in really complicated cases. Now, what's going to happen in this video? You're not going to be given I'm thinking of a number puzzle. Someone's going to give you something like this, an equation to solve, to find x. And you're going to use the balance method to do that. And I'm going to show you how you're going to do that in a second. The key skill you need is if someone gives you an equation to solve like that, you just need to think of it as what happened to x. You need to think, well, I was thinking of a number, I tripled it and got 7.2. So that you know your first step will be to undo tripling it and divide both sides by 3. And that will give you your answer. Okay, so it's just about looking at that, deciding what happened to x, and undoing that process, but without drawing it in a flowchart way. So, pause the video and just tell me what happened to x in each of these cases. So, say a sentence out loud. I'm thinking of a number, and then finish it off for each of these four cases. Well, hopefully you got, I'm thinking of a number, I add 2 and I get 12. I subtract 2 and I get 12. I multiply by 2 and get 12, or double it and get 12. I divide by 2 and get 12, or half and get 12. And it's important that when you look at something like this, you see that I was thinking of a number, I add 2, so that your first step will be to subtract 2 off both sides to get yourselves the answer, x is equal to 10. And obviously in this case, I know, guys, you could have guessed the number was 10 because 10 add 2 is 12. But we're going to end up doing cases where you can't guess the number and it's really complicated. So I'm starting easy, showing you the way to write it in order that you can do it in more difficult cases. So I'm going to do various examples of these. I'm not going to quite write it like this. I've got a new way of writing it that's a bit neater. So let's do some examples. Really focus on writing it the way I do, so that when we get to later videos and we do some really difficult maths, you've got no problem because you write it in the right way. Right, we're asked to solve x add 5 is equal to 12. Think what happened to x. You were thinking of a number, you added 5 to it, and you got yourself 12. I'm going to undo the add 5, but I'm going to write it like this. I'm going to subtract 5 from both sides, and I'm going to do a line underneath it. The reason I'm subtracting 5, I'm undoing that add 5. And I get myself, therefore, that x is equal to 7. 12 subtract 5 is 7. 5 take away 5 gives me nothing here. 12 take away 5 gives me 7. Before I move on, 7 add 5 is 12. And I've got it. I know you could have guessed it, guys, but trust me, I'm going to do harder examples later. Now, I just want to show you this here. If someone asked you to solve that equation there, because addition is commutative, you can add in any order. That's the exact same as solving that equation there, which we did, and we got x is 7. So sometimes you'll see the equations like that, maybe with the x not first. My first line of working is to just say x add 5 is equal to 12 to rewrite it and solve it in the normal way. I like having my x's to the left like that. So there's just a little tip for you. What about this one? Well, I'm going to subtract 5 from both sides to undo the add 5 that I did to x. Draw a line underneath it. I'm going to get x left over here. 5 take away 5 is nothing, but negative 12 take away 5 is negative 17. If you're unsure of why that's true, look back at your negative numbers, because we've done things like that. And negative 17, add 5 is negative 12. I checked it. I got the right answer. Let's do some more. If you feel confident, pause and do it yourself. Okay, I was thinking of a number, I subtracted 5 from it and I got negative 12. To undo the subtract 5, I'm going to add 5 to both sides by the balance method. And what am I going to get? Well, I'm going to get myself x on this side left over. I've purposely added 5 to undo that takeaway 5, so there's going to be nothing there. Negative 12 add 5 is going to be negative 7. Check before you move on, negative 7 takeaway another 5 is negative 12. Yep, I got the right number. Just want to point out a little nuance to you here. Sometimes you might be shown this is the same equation as we've got here. Sometimes the x might be on the other side of the equation. The two things are still equal. It's still the same equation as this. When I see something like this, I just write the x on the left-hand side. I just find it easier to solve like that, and then I proceed. It's always better that you write x equals as your final answer rather than a number equals x. Rather than write something like that, it's always better to have the x on this side. Okay, so just a little pointer there. Right, next one. I was thinking of a number. I subtracted 3 over 2 to both sides, or 1.5, and I got 2. So I'm going to add 3 over 2 to both sides to undo that process. And you just got to be comfortable with adding fractions here. What am I going to get? Well, I'm going to get x is therefore equal to 2 plus 3 over 2. Now remember, 3 over 2 is a mixed number, is 1.5. So x is going to be 2, add 1.5, which is going to be 3.5. You can leave your answer like that. Generally, mathematicians leave their answers when they're fractions in algebra as an improper fraction. So I'd leave that as the improper fraction, 7 over 2. And we're done. Pause and have a go for the next ones. I was thinking of a number. I multiplied by 3 and I got 12. So to undo that, I'm going to divide both sides by 3. Watch how I write this. Divide by 3, divide both sides by 3. And we know by we can cancel the 3 there. We're just left with x is therefore equal to 12 divided by 3, which is 4. And check before you go on, you got it right. 3 times 4 is 12. Yep, happy days, I got that right. Again, sometimes just to point out, you'll see the 12 this side and maybe the 3x that side. But I want you to think of that as the exact same equation as it being this way round. And I would always write it with the x's on the left. Now this one's a useful one to see. Students don't like these normally. I'm thinking of a number. I multiply it by 3 and I get 11. Now this time you can't guess the number. But algebra comes into play here and helps you find the number. I'm going to undo multiplying by 3 by dividing both sides by 3. And I'm going to get myself x is equal to, well, what's 11 over 3? In algebra, guys, it's fine to leave 11 over 3 like that. You don't decimalize it. Whatever you do, don't try and work that out by short division and write a decimal. It's absolutely fine to leave your answer as an improper fraction if it is one. X is 11 over 3, 11 thirds, is our answer, which is cool. And that's done. You don't go off and try and do 11 divided by 3 and work it out as a decimal. Leave it like that. Absolutely fine like that. Okay? Right? Pause and have a go. Same thing, thinking of a number, multiplied by 3 and I got negative 1. Divide both sides by 3 to undo that process and I get myself x is negative 1 divided by 3. Negative 1 divided by 3 and negative divided by positive is a negative answer overall. So I'm going to write that as negative a third, like that. Leave your answer as a fraction, it's fine. Similarly here, I was thinking of a number here. I multiplied both sides by negative 3. So I'm going to divide both sides by negative 3 here. I'm left with x on the left-hand side. And on this side, negative 1 divided by negative 3. Negative divided by negative is a positive. I can leave my answer as positive a third. Look back at your multiplying and dividing by negative numbers if that doesn't make sense. Okay, so here, what did I first do to x? I divided it by 3. To undo that, I'm going to multiply both sides by 3. Now, because I've got a factor of 3 on the top and the bottom, they cancel. I've undone the divide by 3. I just get myself x, my original number, and 12 multiplied by 3 is equal to 36. Check before you go on, you got it right. 36 divided by 3 is 12. Yep, happy days, I got it right. Next one, to undo divide by 3, multiply both sides by 3, just like before. On the left, I'm going to obviously get x. On the right, I've got to be able to do 2 fifths multiplied by 3. So you should know how to do that. If you don't, look back at your multiplying fractions. I think of 3 as 3 over 1. Top times top is 6 over 5 times 1 is 5. I give my answer as 6 fifths. Remember, leaving it as improper is absolutely fine. Don't decimalize it to 1.2. Leave it like 6 fifths. Next one, x divided by 3 is negative 2. To undo the divide by 3, I'm going to multiply both sides by 3, and I get myself x is negative 2 multiplied by 3, which is negative 6. Negative 6 divided by 3 is negative 2. I've checked it, I know I got it right. Last one, I was thinking of a number, I divided by 4 and I got this. To undo divide by 4, multiply both sides by 4. On the left, I clearly get x because I've undone the divide by 4. Now you've got to know negative 3 over 2 multiplied by 4. Think of it as 4 over 1. You may want to cancel a common factor of 2 there, divide by 2 here, and you would get yourself negative 6 over 1, which is just negative 6. So x is negative 6. And if you put negative 6 in there, you'd get negative 3 over 2. Last one, bit of extra practice just for you. I just want to show you the variable is not always x, it can be a, b, c, or d. Pause, try this. I'm just going to show the answers, not going to explain them. Hopefully you got the following. This is a true test. If you understood this video, I got the following. So mark your work there, double check you got it right. If you did, you're ready for the next skill. Thanks for watching.